My mom and my grandma were always, you know, just saying to me how this was a gift, and they really instilled that in me from an early age. Don't take things for granted. And I don't.
Christina Aguilera was known around Pittsburgh as a gifted young singer. Then, the 10-year-old got the chance to take her talent nationwide.
We're still in Rochester at my mother's house, and my mom ran across this tiny, tiny little article in the newspaper about an open audition, or a cattle call, so to speak, for the Mickey Mouse Club. It said that anybody could come, but you had to sing, dance, and act. And you had to come prepared.
Christina and her mom showed up for the local audition, along with 800 other kids.
I just kept looking over and staring at this little girl. I mean, she was so tiny. Everything about her was so small. And she had her blonde hair that was sort of straight down, covering up her face a little bit. And I noticed her because she kind of stuck out.
Aguilera came fully prepared.
She had like 50 songs in a little briefcase, and she opened it up and she said, "What do you want to hear?" I'll never forget it. She started to sing Vision of Love. She sang the entire song and hit every note, riffed, belted, did everything. And when it was over, there was like stunned silence in the room. And then all the kids just started applauding and clapping and going nuts. It was like a star is born for me.
As it turned out, the jaw-dropping performance wasn't enough.
She did a phenomenal job. They were blown away by her voice, but the producers thought she was too young to be on the show.
She was underage, and we didn't know it because they didn't specify the age limits.
Christina was crushed.
I always told her, if this is truly what you want to do, you have to remember, just do your best and then let it go, then move on to the next project.
I kept in touch with her mom and kept her on file with a little picture in her handwritten resume that her mom did. And sure enough, a year and a half, 2 years later, I called up Shelly and said, "Get in your car. She won't have to wait in line. She'll have a private audition. I'll put her on tape, and I can promise you I'll get her on the show."
15,000 kids across the country auditioned. Only Christina and six others were picked to join the cast.
Is she doing a good job on your hair?
Yep.
When she found out she made the show, oh my gosh, she was just crying and jumping up and down.
Christina was on the Mickey Mouse Club with people like Keri Russell, Justin Timberlake, Ryan Gosling, Britney Spears.
They were all like, "I can't believe they're paying us to do what we want to do in our spare time anyway." Christina was not only doing what she loved to do, but for the first time, she was around kids who understood her.
Hi, everybody.
Aguilera signed a 5-year contract, and the family moved to Orlando.
We had to rearrange a lot of stuff and just drop everything for 6 to 8 months out of the year. And that was hard.
We didn't have the money to fly home except for when the season was over and they gave you the ticket home. So we ended up like watching Justin Timberlake's cats while they went home for Thanksgiving.
Working full time and keeping up with school kept the young Mouseketeer busy, but she thrived in the hectic atmosphere.
Christina absolutely loved being on the Mickey Mouse Club. It was like playtime for her every day. It's kind of cool to have a kid who has a passion for something on that level, you know, and then to see them come into their own with some other kids. It's really nice.
Here she had gone from being bullied in school, feeling like a loner, nobody understood her, to being around all of these like-minded people.
Say hi to the camera, Christina.
Hi, camera.
Then, in the fall of 1994, Disney executives announced that the series would end after Christina's second season on the show.
I will never forget everybody hugging each other, those kids. Holy cow. You know, I remember Christina and Brittany just sobbing and holding, because they were inseparable. That was a really, really sad day.
I think Christina, like most of us, we were extremely disappointed. When it was canceled, I think we were all a little devastated. It was like, it was sad.
The hardest part was knowing that you had finally found somewhere that you fit, and then being told that it's over now, we're not going to be doing that anymore.
It was kind of like, well, what am I going to do now? Do I have to go back home? Do I have to go back to all of that?
I made her a little cake, and I got one of those cheesy little trophies where you go to the supermarket or pharmacy and the number one dad on there, except I crossed it out, and I wrote, "Best New Artist." And I said, "Here, sweetie, you know, let's cheer up, you know, just keep doing what you want to do. Just stay yourself no matter what."
there were definitely a couple sessions that we had to say, okay, you know, this probably isn't going to work today because there is too much pressure on her.